Right now I'm going to be taking off the old evap canister and I'm going to be unbolting 3 bolts. Now we can undo the hose. I'm having my dad hold this so I can explain how to take everything off. So we're gonna take off this hose by just wiggling it out. And then we're gonna take off the electrical by pressing the button right here and it'll slide out. And then you're gonna press this black button right here. That one might be difficult. Okay, and then on this one, it's a white button on the side right here. So you push that in. That one's a little difficult too. I'm gonna take that out. And that's it. So I'm going to be installing the rubber bumper and the nut. And I have this over the edge so it's easier to install this. So you're gonna put this through it. And I'm going to be using an 11 millimeter wrench to do this. Okay, I'm going to be putting a nut cert in with our own nut cert tool. Into these things.
One down.
That was hard.
Good job.
That's a lot easier to do it that way.
Point to it.
That one. And the one over there underneath everything. So once you have the evap canister out, you make sure to turn this 180 degrees so the electrical plug is facing out. And make sure before you twist it, you pull up the tab, because if you twist it while not pulling up the tab, then it'll break it off. So be careful with that. found it easier to install the evap canister to the relocation bracket before I put this all onto the Jeep. So I'm just gonna install it right here. So now I can put in the screw and then another side. Now we're securing the evap canister bracket into place. So.
All right. Good.
It's time to relocate the hoses and the wire. So first I'm gonna relocate these, so then it'd be easier for me to run the wire through everything. So I'm going to plug in the wire first, and then I'll plug in the hose. Okay. So it's easy as that, and now my dad can drive his Jeep again.